horizon ring. The Census Bureau produces custom tables for the purpose of providing equal employment opportunity data to human resource, legal, and government professionals and organizations with the data they need to observe and compare population demographic statistics to workforce populations. These data can be used for the purpose of analyzing protected class populations, such as race, sex, and age, by specific occupations. Watch this data gem where you will discover how to find this table tool, what are in these tables, and how to use them in your analysis.
Start by clicking on the link provided below this video to get the latest EEO table release, which as of now is using the 2014 to 2018 American Community Survey 5-year data. These tables are produced approximately every 10 years. The first thing you need to decide is if you want to analyze data for all residents or citizens only. For this demonstration, we are going to use tables for all residents. Once you've found the list of tables, the next step is to select a table. Scrolling down, we see the tables provide data for the protected classes, race, sex, and older workers. Your research question will need to guide your table selection. For today, let's suppose we're looking for the number of female doctors in the city of Dallas, Texas, who are of Hispanic origin, because our organization is checking to see if their workforce percentages match closely enough to the demographics of the local population. Scrolling down, I see occupation by sex and race ethnicity for residence geography. I will select the third table in this section, EEO ALL02R. Let me tell you about how we label the tables. When you see the ALL or all in the table name, it means it encompasses all residents. If we pick the next table, the CIT means citizens, so those tables restrict the data to those with citizenship. Next comes the table number, and this one is 02. Then you will see either an R or a W. The R in the table stands for residents. W means worksite. Residence tables include everyone living in the area, and this includes unemployed workers in the estimates, where worksite tables only offer estimates for those employed in the area. The tool will now guide you through the next step, which is to select a geography. Since Dallas is a city, I will select place. A Select Your State drop-down appears, where we will select Texas, and then the tool enables me to select Dallas City from the next drop-down that appears. Now we can select the button Get EEO Table. And here we are. Once we have our table open, you can click on this sentence, Open Quick Guide to Using Table Tools. This will give you instructions for how to use the buttons you see here below the Quick Guide. I could use the search bar, but my preference is to click on the Search Detailed Occupations button, which allows me to peruse and select my options from a pop-up menu, and also use a search bar. Using this search bar, I will type in physician and select physicians and surgeons. Now the table displays data for that occupation. You can hit Control on your keyboard to select more than one occupation. I also want to select total all occupations to compare those data to physicians. So hitting Control and selecting the first line, I now see I have two filters that are active. Click anywhere outside of the pop-up box to exit. Great, now I see data for all occupations and physicians, and that Hispanic females comprise 14.9%. of the Dallas City population, for the civilian labor force 16 years and over. Selecting the next page of data shows us that the percent of physicians in Dallas City that are Hispanic females is 3.7%. Now you can compare these data to your organization and the compliance standards and goals it has. As you can see, you can do this for any race of interest, or males, or females, and what's truly awesome about these tables is that you can do this for over 200 occupation categories. Another table that may be of interest to your organization would be a table that allows us to compare earnings data. In that case, We are going to want to look at the table employment, median, and mean earnings for occupation by sex and race, ethnicity for worksite geography. For this table, we only have the worksite available and not residents, since we're capturing earnings data for those who are employed. But first, let's click on download to be sure that we save the current table. And we see that the Excel sheet is ready. Click on select new table, then scroll down to the earnings tables. We will select EEO ALL11W. This table allows us to compare employed Hispanic female physicians' incomes to the income for physicians overall in your selected geography. And your organization can also compare these numbers to their workforce earnings data. We'll have to go through the same steps as we did before to select Dallas City. And then just select physicians and surgeons this time. Now we can see that median earnings for Hispanic female physicians in Dallas is $66,875, whereas the median earnings for the total population of physicians and surgeons in Dallas is $195,250. Now, just apply these steps to whatever the occupation or protected class category you're interested in, and you can use these data to compare them to your workforce and analyze gaps in your EEO business practices.
We hope you learned about the Census Bureau's Equal Employment Opportunity Data tables and how to access them. You can also find some EEO data in the tool data.census.gov. Just type in EEO into the search bar to start. Visit census.gov/academy and subscribe so you don't miss when we release new educational videos like this. Thanks for watching.